Section 508 of the Rehabilitation Act of 1973 ensures that millions of Americans with disabilities have equivalent access to information regardless of how they access it. Electronic documents must meet certain guidelines and requirements in order to be compliant with Section 508. Compliance is more than meeting government regulations. At its heart, it's about ensuring all Americans have the opportunity to fully engage and contribute to society. So how do we make Microsoft PowerPoint presentations 508 compliant? Well, we start at the very beginning with a properly named and formatted PowerPoint presentation. The presentation's file name should be clear, concise, and under 30 characters, avoiding spaces and special characters. Document properties should also be filled out correctly. To do this, go to File, and under Info and Properties, click on Show All Properties. Fill out the title, tags, keywords, subject, and author, which should be IHS and the department or organization. It is important to use recommended non-decorative fonts. Times New Roman, Arial, and Helvetica are recommended over Old English or a script, even for headers and titles. Slides must not have background images or watermarks, and must use automatic page numbering fields. PowerPoint has many built-in templates to help create a properly formatted presentation. When writing the actual content, it is important to follow a few rules. All text in each slide must be viewable in the outline view. Use automatic bullet lists available in the application. Do not manually type lists preceded by special characters such as hyphens, asterisks, or windings. Provide an alternate method to emphasizing text. Do not use color alone. A reader who is colorblind may not be able to see the emphasis otherwise. To include URLs in your content, make sure hyperlinks contain the full and correct URL, including http:// or https:// When linking text, avoid using something like click here. Use more descriptive text. If someone is using assistive technology to find hyperlinks in the document, like quickly scanning the document for blue and an underline, the phrase click here will not tell them anything useful about the link. And please note, reserve underlines only for hyperlinks. This helps curtail any visual confusion. When using data tables in a document, there are a few important rules to follow. Avoid using merge cells and keep tables as simple as possible. All tables should be described and labeled. Identify row and column headers starting with the first left-hand column. Tables that span multiple slides must have those headings repeated on each slide. Tables must follow a standard logical reading order, left to right, top to bottom. Don't use tabs or spaces to create table-like structures. Create all tables within the PowerPoint application. Don't copy them from somewhere else. It is important that there is alternative meaningful text provided for each image. Why is this important? Let's look at the following image in a document. An assistive screen reader would read this part of the document as, "Motivational speakers can help motivate your staff. Let's get motivated." Some meaning is lost without the image. So let's add alternate text that will be read by the screen reader. Do this by right-clicking on the image and selecting Format Picture and then the Alt Text tab. What you add here is important. Using the file name of the image or repeating the text around the image isn't helpful. The screen reader will read, "Motivational speakers can help motivate your staff. Let's get motivated. Let's get motivated." Let's try something else. Let's use one word, meeting, in the alt text. Now it reads, "Motivational speakers can help motivate your staff. Meeting, let's get motivated." Meeting is a little bit more descriptive, but the lack of punctuation makes the reader read the sentences incorrectly. One more change. Add a descriptive phrase and the document reads, "Motivational speakers can help motivate your staff. A meeting of people getting excited by a speaker. Let's get motivated." The alternate text now supplies an equivalent experience for the image to a user using assistive technology. Repeat these steps for all other images. Before adding alternate text, make sure all parts of a vector graphic are grouped. Hold Control and select all the related images, and then under the Format tab in the Arrange group, click the Group icon. Don't use animated blinking images for text. Complex images, like charts and graphs, must have alt text that generalizes the overall image and descriptive text immediately following the image. Image layout must be set in line with text for all images. Do not use floating text boxes for graphics or text. And all charts must have a title, legend, and XY axis labels. Finally, make sure that any comments or edits have been deleted or committed to the document. If there is no way to make the presentation as is compliant, create an alternate document that is compliant. The IHS Web Document Specialist will review documents for compliancy as a final check before it goes online. Thanks for watching. Please review the Web Services page for more about Section 508 compliance and IHS Web Standards.